name is Duggie Fields, and welcome to my home. I began painting when I was about 12 years old. My father, my mother, and my brother all took it up as a family hobby. But for me, it became a lifetime project. I guess the turning point in my artistic development was when I was a student at art school, when I was painting what started off as an abstract, minimal, hard-edged, constructivist picture of triangles and squares, and I suddenly placed a figure of Donald Duck in the middle of it, and it transformed the image from abstract to figurative in a big way, but with a small little gesture. I don't know if I have a turning point in my career. I had my first exhibition in the early 70s in Cork Street in London's West End, which was in those days the principal street for an artist to show their work in. Well, my biggest influence is myself. I've been painting since a long time, and when I start a new painting, my biggest reference is what I've just done. When I was younger, I would say I fell in love with most of the greats of 20th century art, but starting with abstract artists more than figurative. I was very keen on Jackson Pollock, I was very keen on Mondrian, very keen on Miro, Picasso, then I would say Dali, Leger, Francis Bacon, Joseph Albers, a host of influences, and they've crept in sometimes consciously, sometimes subconsciously, into my work over the years ever since. My architecture studies were very important to me in that I loved drawing with a set square, a T-square. I loved graph paper. I loved various type of drawing that we were taught to do at architecture school, which I combined with the sketchy type of way that I'd been working previously. Ever since architecture school, I've always had a grid reference to my work. For years, I would work on graph paper with layers of tracing paper on top, and using a ruler, I constructed images, and I would trace and retrace my image until I'd refined it to a point where I thought it was something that I could put on a canvas. In the last decade, I've switched to doing that part of my work on a computer, where the computer automatically puts up a grid, and the programs work in layers, which to me was how I'd been working in the real world before I started working in the virtual world. I started using a computer in 1995. Originally, I thought it was going to be to replace doing collage and to just archive my past. I'd been doing collage for years, where I cut up books and magazines, and I destroyed some lovely books and some lovely magazines, but it was in the name of art, and I made some nice collages out of them. And then I met somebody who I got to scan pictures, and I sat next to him and said, cut this bit off, do this, put this on top of this. And after a while, I got embarrassed at telling somebody else what to do, especially when I wanted to make subtle little movements. Then I got my first computer. Now, there's a story that would take me years to tell about my first computer, but it essentially came about through the death of one of my closest friends. I bought my first computer with money that was left to me in a will of my friend Luciana after she died. And I thought I was just archiving my past on it, but once I started putting images from photographs, I thought they didn't look good enough when I got them on screen. So I started recoloring them to get the color of the original back. But in the process, I found myself destroying the edges of the shapes of the images. So then I thought, well, I'll learn how to restate the edges. So I found myself retracing And retracing is something that I'd always done as a working process. I had a drawing that was layers of graph, tracing paper over graph paper, and I would retrace the outline of the shape, and I found myself doing that on the computer. The first thing that really happened new in the computer was I had a collage that I'd not finished. I'd been working on it in the real world. I scanned it. I looked at it on screen and I found myself turning it into a drawing. Instead of finishing it as a collage, I turned it into a line drawing in the, using the same tracing process that I'd have done in the real world, but in the virtual world. Then I looked at it close up on the screen and enlarged it and enlarged the face. And I suddenly saw that if I changed the face that I'd drawn, if I changed the hair color and added a beauty spot, it was my friend Luciana, the one who died, who'd left me the money that I bought the computer with in the first place. And I printed it, and it was like she popped out of my computer and said, paint me. So I used it as the study and did a life-size painting of her, which is the one I'm wearing on my tie. I met Stanley Kubrick very briefly. He went to see an exhibition I had in Cork Street, my first exhibition there. He liked it enough to somehow get my telephone number and call me up and tell me how much he liked my work and asked me if I would do the poster for the Clockwork Orange, which actually I declined. He had very specific ideas of what he wanted. In the end, I agreed to do a painting for him that didn't contain the graphic elements that he wanted on the poster, but it was a portrait head of Malcolm McDowell. He loved what I did. When he approached me, I'd already read the book of The Clockwork Orange. I'd read it when it first came out earlier in the 60s, and I'd loved it as a book, and I really admired Anthony Burgess as a writer, but I got a very specific view of what I thought it should look like. Then he had me to a screening of the film out in Borehamwood in a screening room with Malcolm McDowell and his girlfriend at the time. Unfortunately, I didn't like the movie and I was very embarrassed because I really didn't like the movie. I did him a painting, he loved it. He rang me afterwards and said, look, please do me something else. And I said, well, I'll think about it. I'll look at the film again. And then I said to him, sorry, I can't do anything else. I think about the art situation in the UK today. Well, it's had a big boom in the 80s and in the 90s. There are a lot of art galleries, there are a lot of artists. If I was starting out to be an artist today, I don't know if I would want to be one. Maybe I would still, I don't know. That's a hard thing to judge, but somehow I think there's too many artists and too many art galleries. I don't go to visit them very often because I'm busy making mine, but now art is highly entertaining. But, I keep on going but when I see how much there is, then I think we should really have a cull of artists and a cull of art galleries, because a lot of art is made for motivations that are to do with maintaining the status quo. Neither, I think, are really what art's about. But what is art about? That's something I can't actually just sit here and express. And if I could, I wouldn't find that I had the need to make it. I'd just sit and talk. On va chercher la femme. On va trouver l'amour. Et toi, dis-moi qui tu m'aimes. Et dis-le-moi toujours.